Welcome to Big Datapedia. So in last video we have seen the architecture up to this Hadoop ingestions. So weblog we can collect the data, and Kafka is going to be referred via this topic name, and Spark is going to be consuming the data according to the Spark topic name, and the data will come to the MySQL table. Those MySQL table we can continuously injecting via scope incremental import to Hadoop environment. This we have seen before. Now we just start from here, and the rest of things we can complete it. So now I just kickstart my code with 15 seconds. So every 15 seconds is going to be inject the data from web API. And Chell also is properly working. Till now it's completed. Now we just want to create a Hive table, and respective operations we can do one by one now. So directly I can go with Hive table. Hive version 2.3.6 I am using, so 2x version. Okay, here also better I can creating a new database. In MySQL I provided with, for the time being I just kill this Airflow. So just I mentioned this as a higher workshop 4. Here I created as Hadoop underscore workshop 4. Okay, I use it now and create an external table on top of where the data will be stored from scope. So this path I just refer it. So same schema I need to provide here. So it should be an external table. Weblog underscore external, it will be stored from ID number, date and IP address, host name, URL and response code. So additionally we have included ID number and date, and then IP address, host and URL, response code. So these is we have to provide. So ID we can provide into the integer format. Date we will not be doing any operations, so simply just provide into the string now. And IP address also string. URL also string. Host also I provide with the string. and response code is, it will be providing any some numeric number, so 100 to 100. So I just providing this one. Create external table, weblog external, and okay, everything I provided, and a row. This is a normal external table. On top of Hive is going to be create external table. It's not a partition table. Once it is created, we can creating a partition table. So row format delimited fields terminated by, it's a comma only, right? Everything will comes with comma. Simply provide with comma. Stored as a text file only, and providing a location. Okay, table created. Let's see some data. Yeah, we can retrieving the data via Hive from Hadoop environment. Now next we will create a partition table. On top of partition table we will be going to injecting the data from this external table to partition table, and that we will be creating into the Airflow scheduler in Hive operator. Once it is successfully working, we can create into the Hive operator. So first we have to create the table name. So here so ID, date value, IP address, host and URL is available. Better I can create via host name, because host will come the repeated only. So one master and 3-4 slave will come again. So based on that we can create here. So same, but I can create as an internal table. So internal table, we don't want to mention anything. Create table and weblog. Partition dynamic weblog dynamic pod. Simply I can provide like this. So create table. Everything I just provide. So ID, date value, IP address, URL, response code, and I need to provide partition table. TATA partitioned by host string, ID, date value, IP address, URL, response code, and partition. I am going to use it as a host name that I have to provide now. Now rest of the same, and location we don't want to provide because as an internal table it will be referred the respective path, user Hive warehouse, database name and table name. That is the directory it will be creating by default. Okay, now it is created. You can see okay, user Hive warehouse, Hadoop workshop 4 database, and web log dynamic part is a path that will be created to the managed table. Now we just going to inject the data into this directory from Hive external table to here. So show tables. So dynamic part and weblog external is available. So here we just going to be use uncorrelated subquery to injecting the data from weblog external. That will help whenever we will be going to execute the query, which are the data is not available from the weblog external. That only will from dynamic partitions and weblog external. It going to be refer what are the data is not available from weblog external. We just check both table what are the data is not available in dynamic partition. That data will be get only from external table and injecting to the dynamic partition table. That is the flow. So we just using correlative subquery to injecting the data. So that's we have to write like that. Insert into dynamic partitions. And host we have to provide, right? So that we have to provide from select ID. Date value, IP address, URL, and response code. So ID, date value, it's not a IP. This is the IP address, URL, and response code. So insert into dynamic partition table, select what are the column I'm going to refer exactly matched with dynamic partition I just provide here, and finally I just providing the host name. From weblog external. If I am trying to execute this command, what will be happen? It's just going to load entire the data into our dynamic partition. So whenever I am going to repeatedly executing the same command, so it's going to be refer entire the data from weblog external, and it is going to be inserted to the dynamic partition. So that's we have to avoid via correlative subquery operations. So what I'm doing here, I just creating this with subquery operations. So weblog external as a table name where not exist exists. Select b.id from weblog partitions as b where a.id equal to b.id. So what will be happen? External table RSS EA, weblog external table ID value, and weblog dynamic partitions ID value, if it is matched, that record is not available. I just mentioning as a not exist. If it is not exist, that only is going to be referred via the select operation. Those data going to be inserted into the dynamic partition. So first time is going to be checked. It's a empty data into the dynamic partition table, so it's going to be inject entire the data into the dynamic partition. Something we missed. semantic host in insert schema specification is not available. Insert into weblog partition host name, select ID, date value, IP address, URL, response code, host from weblog external RSA where not exist b.id from weblog dynamic partitions host in insert schema specification is not found among regular column dynamic partitions. Into weblog dynamic partition stable, everything is correct only. First time we just execute whether it is correct or not. Host in insert schema specification is not found. Okay, I think we have to enable hive executions. So we have for hive dynamic partition we have to set hive execution dynamic partition equal to true. Set hive execution dynamic partition dot mode is non strict. And set hive execute maximum dynamic partitions equal to I provide as 1000. Now I just trying to execute now. It's not found along with insert into table partitions. Insert into table dynamic table partition name we can mention. I think we have to mention this one keyword as well. Yeah, exactly, we missed that keyword. So Hive is running to injecting the data. That only what are the data is available from Hive external table, that record only is going to be injected. and map and reduce. Let's get started. Yeah, properly injecting to the Hadoop environment. High partition table is going to be inject with the 5 partition records. So I just show tables. Select star from high partitions, limit 5. Okay, now the data properly injected. So based on the host name, it will be injected. So NH master node is a host name, that record we can see now. So everything will come to this same name. Okay, so properly it's injecting now. So we just take this query and we just using this query to Hadoop Airflow operations. So before kickstart, we just going to develop the code here and then we just going to kickstart. So scope increment is completed. Now we just going to be import Hive operator. So close to the same only. Instead of bash operator, we can using Hive operator and importing Hive operator. So multiple thread is running in the PyCharm, so it's throwing this kind of error. So I just mentioned here some high partitions and directly I can using this Hive operator. This Hive operator will be expecting task ID, CLI operations and query where it is the query and DAG ID. So that will be expected. HiveQL we can providing asset query directly. Connections we need to provide and task ID we need to provide. Let's see. So first we can provide Hive connection. I have used Hive local. So I just mentioned Hive local connections. And then HQL here Hive EMD. Simply I just mentioned this is the actual command. Use and DB name we also we have to provide here. Hadoop workshop. And if it is a dynamic partition, then we need to provide that 3 set options as well. So simply I just copy and paste that. Yeah, So Hadoop environment, I just mentioned, and set options, and finally I just providing this command to execute. So this is the Hive query. So I'm using Hive command as a Hive query directly. Okay. So Hive connection I provided, Hive query I provided. And task ID, Hive partition loading. And finally providing DAG ID. So this 4 is enough. We don't want to provide anything more than this. And this Hive partitions have to call here. After scoop, I just mentioned Hive partition, and then we have to call finish task. And we just go with scheduler into that once operations. Okay. We have kickstart our scheduler as well. So I just kickstart again web server and scheduler both. So once it is properly popped up, then we can see. Okay, so scope increment is created. Hive partition loading has also will be included now. We didn't miss anything, I guess. I hope. And now first scope injection is completed, then rest of that is going to be load the data. Before that, we just checked out what of the data is available. Just check the maximum value into the Hive partition table. Count of just take maximum ID from weblog dynamic partitions. Mapper is completed, ready to get started now. And check it out, what is the maximum value in this? Okay, 506 is available. Now we just going to be execute this job. New job is executed. We'll see. scope job is completed, then only Hive partition table is going to be kickstarted. Scope job is queued now. Okay, scope job is now running. Job is completed. So we can see in this path, if the data is come, the next one of part 04 will come here. Okay, scope job is completed. Now Hive partition table is going to be executed now. Hive running started. Partition is loading now. Still Hive partition table is loading the data. If it is succeeded, then finally we will be importing the data via Spark aggregation operation, and that Spark aggregation, so we can schedule via Airflow with Spark submit operator. Then finally it will be combined and all the operation we can see directly here, and Grafana helps to review all the data in dashboard. Yeah, job is completed successfully now. So due to the standalone, it takes long time to execute that entire operations. If you will be work with multi-node cluster, then it very faster. You can see the data previous, it was 506. Meanwhile, I just stop workflow scheduler, because I'm executing sequential executor. So multiple thread is running the backend and CPU's performance is going very low. Before it was 506. value is very high. So 683. So properly just injecting all the data and following with our timelines. So now scheduler is properly working from weblog to high partition table, and so we will be connected properly now. Next we will be going to work with Spark, and we will be developing the code into the Spark and aggregate the data. We just confirm before to proceed that Spark submissions. Okay, so everything is a string only, response code only we have in integer. So we just take some values and we just going to be refer into this response code as well, or URL. So both only little different, rest of this is look like the same. So via host is a group by operation, we just applying this URL and response code both. Okay, now we just develop the code. So this is the file name I am going to create now, Spark Hive aggregation output. So it's going to be called that Hive table and load the data into the Spark data frame, and then it will be make some group by or combination via Spark Hive integration data frame, and final output we will be going to store again to data MySQL table. That's already we have designed, so that's we will be going to develop now. I'm importing by Spark, and by Spark dot SQL dot session, just import Spark sessions, and from PySpark we can creating a Spark session. Spark open to Spark session dot builder app name Spark Hive integrations. And set master asset local. Spark session builder app name master enable Hive support and getter create. And directly I can use now with Spark SQL use DB name, I forget, so better that we can get from here. from, okay, this is I'm going to load into the one data frame. So this data frame, group by, and before I can create as a new data frame by instead of that directly we can using a single query, right? Now it will be work into the Hive table and then it will be provided, so we can using here by we can go with we tend to have very much data, so simply we can using that command. Host and IP address we can see here, right? Host and IP address we can get from here. TDRESS. So select host and IP address. Count of URL is a string value, so simply we can take as a count value here. As total comma sum of response code, as total response. For the sake I just providing this, but response code is a code number. Both will come to the same, so that for the integer I just providing to the sum operations. Okay, select host IP URL and responses code, everything we just created out from table from Hive partition table. Group by order by okay, so directly I can refer the data frame and create it out. Now I just going to inject into that MySQL table. JDBC URL have to provide. So scope job we provided the URL name. So same database in MySQL table we are going to inject. So MySQL database name workshop 4, we just going to be inject the data. So same is correct, and table it was only one, so directly we can create from the schema. highest power aggregate, and then mode we can provide over write. And then properties, it is expecting the properties so properties we have to provide that arguments user root password, also root a driver com dot MySQL CJ yeah correct so user ID password and driver name three we have to provide by default so that everything I just provided now first we just kickstart this and then we'll see can open in the terminal so simply I provide spark hyphen submit and spark hive aggregation dot py we can see before started we can see show tables we don't have any table so same database we just executed now and we'll see So Spark job is executing now. It's successfully completed. Data is not coming, I guess. Select mismatch input by expecting the frame. Count URL total sum of response code from dynamic partition group by host and the IP address. Order by host and IP address. Better we can execute this command. If it is incorrect, we can try in different way. Okay, everything it will be expected in the same line. Yeah, it's working fine. This is not required, I guess. I just provide into the single line itself. Yeah, now this command is working fine. Sorry, something is wrong again. I think it's injecting the data into the MySQL table. Yeah, so high spark aggregation has been creating. So properly now this data is injecting. Once the job is completed, we can see what is the value. Select star from yeah, properly it's injecting the final output we can see here. Now we're just going to create it Grafana with this values. So just I'm going to create a Grafana now into the new dashboard. And once properly Grafana is created, then we can go into once properly design the Grafana dashboard, then we just going to create the highest fog summit via Airflow continuous scheduler, and we can see enter the output in Grafana. So by default Grafana is running backend. Workshop underscore foo. I'm creating a dashboard folder. In this folder I'm going to create the table. Before just get started, we just going to connect via properly into the MySQL DB. So this is a test DB only just connected. So we just go on creating a data sources. Okay, databases. Workshop 4 that we can take it out. Now I just saved and go to this. Workshop 4 we have, right? So just go to the manage and open the dashboard. Before coming to the dashboard, we just going to select respective table names and databases. Simple, I just provide select start from tables. order by date. Limit 5. Okay, we can see where ID number and descending. So I just edit the title name. Okay, so now we can see the data actually. We can schedule for every 5 seconds now. I'll just make it as a duplicate here. We can make one more duplicate down. But I can add a new order by host. So this is the host detail we can see here. Just going to change the panel detail. So Hive aggregate, we can see log details, we can see here. Okay, so Hive aggregate output we can see here. Now here I just going to change the value as well as some dashboard I just creating here. That's we can see some values. I just convert from visualization table to some charts. That's a bar chart or something. So total output we can see. Chart. So this is the best way. So simply I just developed some dashboard and we can see the data. So every 5 seconds whether the new data will come, it's just going to be refresh here and injecting it, and while we will be making some scheduler based on that, Hive aggregation will be executed based on every 15 minutes and it will be continuously changing the values. So like this we have developed now. Okay, Grafana is working and rest of the part is also working here. Web block, Kafka integrations, everything we just completed until the Spark and aggregated with the Grafana. So everything is completed. Only Airflow is going need to submit with the Spark submit operator. If Spark submit operator is also working, then this operations entirely will be scheduled. Now I'm going here and I'm going to create a Spark submit operator. So Spark submit operator also is available in operator only. Operators dot okay, so I think it will with the contribution operator. Yeah, exactly. It comes from Spark submit operator. So contribute operator will be providing Spark submit operator. now we just going to be Spark submissions. So Spark submit operator. We'll be expecting applications and connection ID, and that's a Python file only, so directly we can refer it in that connection ID itself, and application we can provide with that Python file. And configuration by default will be, we will be providing that connection ID, and task only I think we have needed. So connection ID, we need to provide, so spark underscore local, that is I'm using, and application. So this application I have to provide where this Python file is located. So this is the job, right? Spark Hive aggregations. Connection applications. DAG. And task ID. Submission. Okay, so connection ID, application ID, task ID, and DAG we just provided. I think that's it. After scoop, after high partitions, then we need to use this Spark submission. Finally, it's going to be worked with the finished task. I think it's working. It's just going to be scheduled in the if both is successfully running the continuous injections, we can schedule. So now Spark submission also included. Now we just going to execute that entire operations now. So scope increment, once it is done, high partition is going to be executed. High partition is completed, then Spark submission is completed. So until this, we don't have Spark submission, now only we just included, so that it will be showing as a no status. Now it's included, now I'm going to trigger the jar. just kickstart. Okay, so job is started. Scope job is just started now. So scope job once done, hive partition is going to be started. Yeah, scope job is completed. Next hive partition is going to be executed. Yeah, hive partition job is started. Now hive partition is loading now. Yeah, hive partition table is completed now. Then Spark submission is going to be started. Spark submission is in queue now, so it's going to be start. Yeah, okay, Spark submit is in running now. So all the data is injecting, and on top of that it's going to be validated. Now the weblog details is loaded, all the data, so it will be reached into the 942 now. Add path also loading the data. So external table is properly loaded, and from external table to hive partition table is properly loading the data. Now Spark submit is going to refer all the data and injecting to the hive aggregations, and those data we can see via this dashboard as well. If aggregate values change, then it will be completely modifying the values. So now Spark is going to be injecting the data into this table, like so. If injected properly, then if every 5 seconds once, just going to be refresh, and that new refreshed data you can see here still running, and no data is available in this table because we have provided overwrite options. So entire the data has been vanished, and a new data only will come to this part. We'll see for some time, and we'll, yeah, I think job is completed because the job is completed. Then final dummy task is going to be completed. So we have seen entire that scheduler right now. If you need to change the value from hard points to aspect your times, so every 30 minutes they will be scheduled. So as per the cron tab, they will be providing the schedule timings. If you schedule it like this, then every 30 minutes one job is going to be executed. So airflow is properly working. and before it was showing as what once. Now we just scheduler, we just change into that. Scheduler will be updated in some time, then it will be properly injecting the data as per the our schedule timings. Okay, so hereafter it will be follow this timings based on the schedule timings, all the execution flow whatever we have mentioned, it's going to be run in the back. So entire the operation we have seen just before. So every 5 seconds once it's just going to be repeat the data only. If every 5 seconds the continuous injection is happening to the highest power aggregation, so you can see. But now that weblog details every 15 seconds is going to be inject the data into this part. So you can change the value for the 3 times of 5 seconds. But this aggregation, whenever the Spark submit is executed, at the time you can see the total values and total responses. Like this, we have scheduled the operations. Now you can see Hadoop workshop also will be changed into the every 30 minutes as we mentioned. Hereafter, it's continuously trigger and execute all the flows of values. And you can see the output here. That's it. So we have seen all the operation with complete hands-on today. So sources, weblog, Kafka integration, Spark streaming and MySQL, incremental import, Hadoop, Hive partition, Spark and aggregated MySQL and Grafana and integration with the Airflow. So these 8 is mostly using for the big data environment. That's we are seeing just before. That's it. Thank you. And please provide your valuable feedback or comments below. If it is valid, we will go through with that and we'll get back to you. Thank you.